Today I'm working on a Stihl MS661C. This will be video number 3 in the series on this saw. This video will detail how to replace the rim sprocket and clean out the brake band and clutch drum area of the saw. Part number for needle cage. Part number for a 3/8 7 tooth rim sprocket. When you're replacing rim sprockets on saws, make sure that you're buying the correct rim sprocket for the type of chain and bar that you're running. A screwdriver will pick that E-clip. If you put your finger over it and catch it, you won't fire it off into the universe. The retaining washer lifts out. There is a cup area that faces up so that the E-clip can fit in it. The backside is flat. Good idea to replace both of those as well. The rim sprockets are labeled, and you can see there 3/8 and a 7. If you release the brake lever, you can get the clutch drum to slide out. We get a buildup of debris on them. There we go. It's a good idea to take off the piled up debris here so they're not dragging. That'll make the chain continue to run. And of course, while you have them opened up, inspect the three clutch springs to make sure none of the hooks are broken and none of the center hub areas are broken. A lot of the guys will fire the saws up with the chain brakes on, which engages the clutch, because when you initially start a saw, it's setting in a fast run position on the throttle trigger. And some will even hammer the throttle a little bit with the brake on. So you'll find these areas of the saws are all melted because they've gotten so hot. You'll also find a bunch of debris packed in behind the brake band all the way around, and the brake band is not able to expand fully and let go of the clutch drum. So the drum will drag and the chain will run all the time because of that debris buildup or because of a melted interface here. Here's an example of the debris that builds up. I've racked the brake lever back and forth a bunch of times and used a small screwdriver to dig out around the brake band. It's currently pulled inward because I have the brake lever forward and the brake is engaged. So I'm digging out all this section here to get the debris out of it. And there was a bunch of debris packed into these web areas as well. But now there's a bunch of plant material right here. So what I'm going to do is take off this plastic cover. You can see right here, the saw is all eroded. That's what happens when saws are used to trim palm trees and then they're not cleaned up afterwards. The acids in the palm trees eat the saws, and it is the death of saws where I'm at because there is a lot of palm tree work done here. That's probably what these fibers are. So we'll get that cover off and do more cleaning. This cover is just glued in place with all the debris. You can see what's built up around it, and then what's packed into the saw. This stuff was packed in around the base of the cylinder when I first started to inspect the machine also. But it interferes with the operation of all these components. So the whole brake area is jammed up with this stuff. I'm going to dig around more off camera and then blast this all out with compressed air. Okay, all cleaned up, and I want to now inspect the arm that drives the oil pump. You'll see it right there. And I want to make sure that that travels all the way around freely, because it's driven by the drum. You can see it down in there. It's going to be blurry because the camera won't focus on it. It engages that notch, and that notch is indicated for installation by that scribe mark. So before you put the clutch drum on, find that tab, and then you lower down onto it based on your scribe mark being in the same spot. All right, the brake band has been released. I'm going to install the clutch drum with this cover off. I've got the drive for the oil pump down in the 6 o'clock position, so I'll put my scribe mark in the 6 o'clock position. I'm going to drop it in without the bearing because the brake band is kind of distorted at the top. And that just engaged the drive. Little engine oil on my bearing. Make sure it's all settled down and flush. It won't be flush. It'll pivot if it's not installed correctly. Sprocket on with the lettering facing out. And we have a new washer. Light pressure on these to get them to start threading. Okay, verified Euler function. Starts on one pole and runs great. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you out.